Imagine, you order 10 Hidden Fates Elite Trainer Boxes for about $10 below what the market value is, and you get them all, only to realize they're all resealed. They don't have Hidden Fates packs in them. What's going on, everybody? Welcome back. You're watching the channel Dr. Applesauce 2. My name is Will. It's another beautiful day in Texas. I hope you guys know I love you, God loves you, and that there is a wonderful plan for your life. Today, we have, quite unfortunately, two Hidden Fates Elite Trainer Boxes. One of these is real, and one of these is resealed and fake. Can you tell which one? Drop me a comment down below. Let me know. If this is your first time here and you like all things Pokemon, I do try to bring you guys two or three videos a week on Pokemon. We got openings, 101 videos. If you want to stay up to date, make sure to hit that subscription button and that notification bell so you don't miss any of the uploads. That's right, my friends. Right here, we have two Hidden Fates Elite Trainer Boxes. One of these is a real Elite Trainer Box, and one of these is a fake Elite Trainer Box, or an Elite Trainer Box that was resealed, all of the Hidden Fates packs taken out, and then other packs put back in. From these little images right here, which is essentially what you would get if you were ordering them online, this is the type of quality that you would get from pictures online, can you tell which of these Elite Trainer Boxes is the real genuine one and which one is not the genuine one? Now here's the tricky thing about this. They're both real boxes. Both of the actual boxes are real Hidden Fates Elite Trainer Boxes. So all your box artwork and everything, all that stuff is actually going to be true and what it should be, but it's the contents of the inside of one of them that is bogus. So which one do you think is real? Which one do you think is fake? Drop a comment down below, left or right, to cast your vote, because I'd love to know. All right, before I show you which one of these is real and which one of these is fake, I want to tell you the story. This is actually from one of my good buddies, Magnus, and he bought 10 Hidden Fates Elite Trainer Boxes for, I think he paid a little bit below what like the actual market value is. And once he got them, he felt them and he realized this doesn't feel right. And he opened one of them and it was full of Sun and Moon base packs. So I wanna say he paid around $90 to $100 on each one, and then he got them all and they were full of Sun and Moon base booster packs. So he actually saved one and sent it to me so I could show you guys what a sealed or resealed slash fake slash scam Hidden Fates Elite Trainer Box looks like. So shout out to Magnus for hooking me up with this. And this is just a cautionary tale to show you that like Magnus knows a ton about Pokemon cards. He is a much better Pokemon card collector than I am. And even the best of us can get fooled sometimes, because there are ways out there to really, really, really very, very professionally reseal things. So it's really sad. So unfortunately, we do have a resealed Hidden Fates Elite Trainer Box and a real Hidden Fates Elite Trainer Box. And let's see which one we think it actually is. So if you guessed in the comments down below that the left Hidden Fates Elite Trainer Box was the fake and the resealed one, you would be incorrect. The left Hidden Fates Elite Trainer Box is actually the real one. The right Hidden Fates Elite Trainer Box is actually the fake resealed Hidden Fates Elite Trainer Box. Now, can you tell why? If you guessed correctly, what were some things that you saw just from me showing you a few images that helped you determine which one was the real one? So a few things to look out for. It's a little bit difficult to tell in pictures when you're buying online, but in person, there's a few things you can really look for. So what's happening a lot with ETBs nowadays is I'm hoping that you guys can see, let's get some glare on there. These Elite Trainer Boxes that are real have these teeny tiny little holes in the packaging. And it's supposed to, it's kind of like an aeration type of a thing, I believe. But there's these teeny tiny minuscule holes in the packaging. And on this one, there is nothing like that. You can see this one is just perfectly solid. But on this one, see if I can get the glare, you might be able to see there, you can see a few of the holes. You see some of the holes right there in the light? You can see a few of the holes. Next, the big thing is Elite Trainer Boxes all are sealed with this same type of material, okay? So here's a great place to tell. You can look at the seams. The seams look pretty darn similar if you're just looking, but if you feel the seams, you can really tell. So Elite Trainer boxes, just like booster boxes, modern booster boxes, are sealed with what is almost like a saran wrap, plasticky wrap type of a cling wrap seal. It's stretchy, you can stretch it, and it has a certain feel to it. Like, listen, and go like this. It doesn't really sound, it just, you know. But what you'll see a lot on resealed Elite Trainer boxes is the seal that they use, the plastic that they use, is not that you know, malleable, saran wrap, plastic wrap type of stuff that's stretchy. It's more of a solid, much more rigid plastic wrap. You can even hear it, right? And you touch it, you can feel it. Like, listen to that. Versus listen to this. Because the real Elite Trainer boxes are sealed with, like I said, more of a saran wrap style plastic wrap. And usually when you see resealed ones, they're gonna be in this harder type of a wrap. And just for your average Joe, that's really all that you can look for. So if you had both of these in hand, you would be able to tell. But say you were just meeting up with somebody to buy this one, and all you had was this one right here, what are you gonna do? Well, I'm gonna look and I'm gonna see, okay, are there any holes? There's no holes in it. That's my first, you know, big warning. And then I'm gonna come over here to the seal and I'm gonna feel, okay, that doesn't feel like saran wrap like it should feel. I'm using common terms, right? Things that everybody's gonna understand. That doesn't feel like saran wrap. That feels different. It doesn't feel like the nice plasticky, you know, stretchy type of a wrap we normally get. There's something off on this, and I'm gonna pass that deal up. Whereas over here, if I'm looking at this one, I'm gonna see, okay, and you're gonna see like there's gonna be imperfections because this wrapping tears when it hits on things, right? The fact that there's imperfections doesn't mean it's fake. And the fact there are no imperfections, look how perfect this one looks. The fact that there are no imperfections doesn't mean it's real, okay? So that's what I'm gonna look for, is those type of things. So let's take this real one. We're gonna set this real one over here, and let's take this resealed one, and we're gonna open up. Now I want you to listen really good right here. This is how you can really know. So you start to open it up and listen. You hear that? That's not what a typical seal on an Elite Trainer box sounds like when it opens. It's way too rigid, way too tough. It's just, it's not the same thing. It's not right. It's way too rigid. You hear? And let's go ahead and crack this one, because why not? Let's open some Hidden Fates packs. So this is our real one. Now listen to this one when I open it up, okay? Listen to this one, how the difference is. You hear that? There's no sound almost compared to the other one. So here's the wrapping on our real one, listen. And here's the wrapping on the reseal. You hear that? There's just a massive difference. This is a much stretchier type of a material, okay? And this is a much more rigid type of a almost candy wrapper, and it's a lot louder. It's a lot louder than what you're normally gonna have. So that's the biggest giveaway. So we'll toss those aside and let's take the resealed one and take a look at what's gonna be on the inside of it. I already have an idea. And look, they put everything in there, okay? I have no idea if the promo's in here. I doubt the promo will be in here. And so what are we gonna get? We're gonna open this resealed box, and what do we have? Oh, wow. These aren't even closed packs. Oh, wow. Oh, no. We have a bunch of Sun and Moon, and they're opened. Look at that. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, and 10. Opened Sun and Moon packs. They were kind enough to give us the die and the damage counters, energies. We got the sleeves, and obviously no promo, because these scammers took everything of value out of here. Now, I have seen times before where they actually just put full-on Sun and Moon packs in there, but look at these. Every single one of these is opened. Well, that one doesn't look like it's opened. All opened and stuffed with something else, or resealed terribly. I just dropped one on the ground. So let's see which one. This one actually looks like it might be sealed. That's open. That looks like it might be sealed. That looks like it could be just factory. Okay. So it's very interesting. Like, it looks like, to me, it looks like they put some sealed ones and some resealed ones in here. It doesn't make sense. Let's see what kind of garbage we got in these. So these are the ones that straight up look like they're open. Sun and Moon base. Code card that probably doesn't work. Are these even real? Are these even real Pokemon cards? Okay, these are real Pokemon cards. You can tell because you've got the black ink right there. So at least that's a real Pokemon card. I don't expect there to be anything in here though. Energy, two energies, and a reverse Alolan Persian. Okay. This other one that's open. So yeah, like that's crazy. They're not even sealed. Drowsy, Fearow, Shellder, reverse, Bounsweet, Incineroar, energy. It's interesting that they were opened. Let's see, Skarmory. I doubt there's gonna be anything good. A reverse Dragonite that feels really weird. I don't know, man. That doesn't feel right. The texturing on that card, it doesn't feel right. So those were all ones that were unsealed. I don't know if some of these don't feel right. These feel like they've been searched through as well. So seems like this might be a double scam where they actually took out all of the good cards from the Sun and Moon base packs, as well as took out the Hidden Fates packs. Cause yeah, that's opening way too easy. And it actually looks like they might've been cut. Not sure. So these are just things to look out for, guys. I bet you every single one of these, we're gonna get a reverse holo. And that's all there. Yeah, these are definitely resealed packs because they just open way too easy. There's our reverse holo and our regular rare. Look at that. Watch how easy this opens. Just, yeah, that's definitely not factory glue. And reverse holo. Oh, we actually got a holo Crobat in that one. So out of 10 packs, no hits, right? So at first, I initially thought they might have just stuffed it full of Sun and Moon. Sun and Moon packs, but no, they stuffed it full of resealed Sun and Moon packs, which is even worse. Holy cow, like if you're gonna rip somebody off, at least give them something to open. Yep, we got another reverse, and that's about it. So this entire ETB, all resealed packs, the ETB itself was resealed with Sun and Moon base packs, which is super lame. And they took out all the hits and replaced it all with garbage. So there's some stuff to look out for. How mad would you be if you paid $100 for that and that's all you got? It's possible to open an ETB and get zero hits, but obviously those were resealed with poor glue and it was a poor job resealing them. All right, well, let's have some fun with the end of this video. This is a real Hidden Fates Elite Trainer box right here. So this one should have actual Hidden Fates booster packs in it. And we are going to open them up. So damage counter, boom, energy. Hey, we actually have a code card. Okay. And Hidden Fates, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Got some Hidden Fates packs and our promo. So this is all this stuff that was missing from the last one that everything that was worth anything was taken out of. Alrighty, y'all, well, let's have some fun. It's been a while since I opened Hidden Fates. We're gonna use a Hidden Fates Elite Trainer box as an example. A real one, might as well open it. We got ourselves 10 packs of Hidden Fates to open up today. Let me know down in the comments what you think. Have you ever seen a resealed Hidden Fates box like that? Have you ever seen anything, you know, to indicate that you bought a resealed box? Did you learn something from this video? Drop me a comment down below and let me know. And we've got 1, 2, 3. Burn the fairy energy. And let's kick it off with a Giovanni's Exile, Brock's Grit, Koga's Trap, Ekans, Koffing, Paris, Cubone, Voltorb, a reverse holo Jinx, and a regular rare Eevee. Not a terrible card to pull. All right, let's go into Hidden Fates pack number 2. I think the last Hidden Fates pack that I opened was at Collecticon. I did like this little wheel spin game and actually pulled a Hidden Fates pack from it, which was actually pretty cool. 1, 2, 3, and we're going to burn the metal energy. I would love to get that Charizard for once. Scyther, Metapod, Voltorb, Koffing, Ekans, Cubone, Magikarp, Paris Reverse, and an Arbok Regular Rare. Arbok Regular Rare. Now, how cool would it be if the Hidden Fates Elite Trainer box that I used to actually show you guys what a real Elite Trainer box looked like had some good hits in it? How funny would it be if it didn't have any hits in it at all? I see something on the back of this that could be nice, actually. So I'm not sure if I saw a reverse holo just now or what, but 1, 2, 3, and we're going to burn the fighting energy. What do you guys think about Hidden Fates? I think Hidden Fates is fun. I think the price that Hidden Fates packs have is weird because we continually see Hidden Fates Elite Trainer boxes pop up in big box stores. So I don't know if the price is justified, but it is a great set. There is a great Pikachu card, and we have a Giovanni's Exile and a Gyarados EX. Thought we hit something cool, but still, Gyarados EX is it's a decent hit from this set. Very cool card. There is a promo Gyarados GX as well. But this one is just a little bit different artwork. All right, let's go on to the Mewtwo pack. And I can't believe I'm opening these. I almost think Hidden Fates, you just lose money when you open it. But sometimes you just gotta have some fun. So let's see if we got ourselves a good Elite Trainer box here at this time. 1, 2, 3. And burn the metal energy. So what did you guys think about the fake resealed one? It sucks that people do that, man. It's not cool. But if you pay attention and you look real close, you might be able to spot those things, especially if you're doing in-person meetups. Online, it can be hard. Like I showed you in those pictures, it would have been pretty difficult to know online if that was a resealed box. Sabrina's suggestion and Bill's analysis. So far, we have four duds and one eh. So let's see what we get this time around. We have a code card for you guys. 1, 2, 3, and burn the darkness energy. You think the darkness is your ally? Scyther, Metapod, Snake Backward, shout out to Pokeran, Pikachu, Clefairy, Jigglypuff, Reverse Clefairy, and a Team Rocket. That card is thick. Team Rocket, Holographic, Zapdos pack. I hope we can get a baby shiny. I don't know. We'll see. But a lot of people like to compare Hidden Fates and Shining Fates. What do you think? Which do you think is more fun to open? Personally, I think Shining Fates is just so darn fun to open. I never had a situation where I opened Shining Fates that I didn't at least have some fun. Simply because the pull rates are just ridiculously good in Shining Fates. And you can't help yourself but opening it and smiling and giggling when you hit baby shinies and stuff like that. So, speaking of a baby shiny, we have a baby shiny Beldum, our first hit. Nice. And this is actually a baby shiny for Hidden Fates that I do not have. So that is really, really nice. So we got baby shiny Beldum and Erica's Hospitality. So let's get Beldum sleeved up. By the way, how about the new sleeves that Pokemon is putting in their Elite Trainer boxes? This is a Champion's Path one. The new sleeves that are frosted, they're terrible. Pokemon, stop doing that. Those sleeves are terrible. You put a holographic card in it and you can't even really tell that it's holographic anymore. I don't know why they're doing that. It's just, it's not good. Oh, we got a GX. We got a GX. All right, there's the code card. 1, 2, 3. Burn the lightning energy. Give daddy a shiny GX. That would make me mucho happy today. Koffing, Cubone, Geodude, Jigglypuff, Staryu. Oh, Aether Foundation employee, full art trainer. I don't have that card. I have not pulled it yet. The texture is really cool. Can you see their eyes pop? Like their eyes aren't textured. Their eyes are flat. Oh, pretty cool. All right. Aether Foundation employee, full art trainer, and a Raichu GX. Okay, that was a double banger right there. That was a double banger. Come on, Raichu. There you go. We got a Raichu GX and a Gyarados GX and a full art trainer. That is cool. That makes this ETB worth opening right there. Makes me happy, happy, happy. All right, guys, we have 3 packs left. Drop me a comment down below if you think I am going to hit a full art GX shiny today. That would be very cool. I'd love to know what you think. We have a code card, and 1, 2, 3, we're gonna burn the fairy energy. We got a Brock's Grit, Scyther, Jinx, Pikachu, Ekans, Coughing, Paris, Cubone, Brock's Grit, and Nada Denada. All right, Charizard, bring us the shiny Charizard GX. I can't pull the shiny Charizard VMAX to save my life, so maybe today we can pull the shiny Charizard GX. 1, 2, 3, and we're gonna burn the fire. Ooh. Charizard, let's get it. Misty's Determination, Metapod, Charmeleon, Staryu, Ekans, Caterpie, Paris, Charmander. Oh my gosh. If there's a Charizard in here, this is like the most stacked Charizard ready pack. We got Charmeleon, Charmander, holographic fire energy, regular fire energy, and we have, Kangaskhan, regular rare. Well, that's still cool to pull right there. Boom, pretty card. Last pack magic. So, if you paid $100 for this Elite Trainer box, would you be happy with these pulls? Something you always got to think about when you're buying Pokemon cards, and when you're willing to spend more than MSRP on things, is if you would be happy with, you know, opening the product if you got good pulls or not. So 1, 2, 3. We're going to burn the leaf energy. Guys, if you enjoyed this video, hit that subscription button and that notification bell. I hope you learned something about identifying a resealed Elite Trainer box. Kind of a few things to look for. Just be careful out there, because unfortunately there are shady people wherever there's money to be made looking to take advantage of somebody else. So drop me a comment down below if you'd learned something. Hit that subscription button and let's get some last pack magic. Brock's Gym, Giovanni's Exile, Cubone, Eevee, Clefairy, Psyduck, Ekans, Reverse Scyther, Rats, and a Holo Zapdos. Cool card. We got 4 hits. Not terrible, but you got to think, when you're buying these more expensive Elite Trainer boxes, are you happy with spending $100 on a box and pulling $30 worth of cards? You got to make that decision for yourself. All right, my friends, I hope I earned your subscription today. I hope you check out some of these other videos right there. If you haven't already, hit that subscription button and that notification bell. And like I always say, find somebody to love and serve today and be the change you want to see in the world. We'll see you next time.